The next element in the document is links, and a link can be created by using the A tag, also known as the anchor tag. As we know, the anchor tag helps us to move onto a different website or a different web page, and you have to specify the particular URL of that web page. Links are created using the A tag element, and the A stands for anchor. A link has two main parts: the destination and the label. So with this A tag or the A element, we make use of the attribute href. Okay, and for this href value we have to give is the link to which website you want to go to. So this link, we call it as the destination part, and this part which is there, this is known as the label. Okay, so when you execute a web page, this label which is there, only that will be seen in the browser and not this destination. So what will happen is your web page will be there. In that web page, this central part only will appear, and below that you will get a line. So when you'll click on that central part, it will take you to the web page centralpark.com. So this part is called as the destination part, and this part is called as the label part. Okay, so a link has two main parts: the destination and the label. Here they have one more example, and that is here. This is just a web page. Okay, it's not a website. It is just a web page or a web code .html. So you're not going to any website or anything. You are going to a particular page, and that also which code it is? HTML code. And in that particular page, you are visiting its logo. Okay, so you are visiting its logo. So destination is not given, because the destination will be the same page, and in that page you are clicking the logo, you have visited the logo. So the label here will be, that is, if I click on this label, it will take me to that particular logo. So next we'll be studying the different types of links which we can make use of by using the A tag. You can use the anchor element to create a wide range of links. So which are those links? Links to external sites or to individual resources such as images or movies on an external site. So A tag is usually most probably used for, most used is only to go for external sites. In that external site also, you can go to a particular resource, or you can go to a particular image, or you can go to a particular movie on that external site. So A tag is not only used for going to that website, but also you can go to that particular part of that website. Okay, then the next thing is that links to other pages or resources within the current site. Okay, so presently at which site you have gone to, in that you can go to pages, different pages, or to different resources. Next is links to other places within the current page. So in the current page, you want to go to other places also, then also you can make use of the A tag. Next is links to particular locations on another page also is available. Links that are instructions to the browser to start the user's email program. Okay, so in your web page, if you click, it will directly go to the email account of that user. So that link, that email account link also, you can give it directly in your A tag by using that in your HTML code. The next is links that are instructions to the browser to execute a JavaScript function. So link, you can give an instruction, and that instruction will execute another JavaScript function. So A tag can also be used for this particular work. Next we have is the different link destinations. So using A tag, which all links you can make use of. In the first one, for the href attribute, the link given is a link to an external site. That means you are visiting the site of Central Park. That website's URL you have to give. So this is the first example. In the second example, what is happening is the value which is given here for href, it is a link to resource on external site. That means of Central Park logo you are visiting. Okay, so immediately your cursor will go on to the logo of that website. So it is a link to resource on external site. Then the third example here is link to another page on same site as this page. Okay, so the website is the same, but you are visiting the different page of that website. Same website, but different page. So that page's address is being given here. It is not given in the form of path, because the path is the same, only the page is different. Okay, in the fourth example, what they have given is link to another place on the same page. That means you are in the same page, but you are visiting a other place. That is, here they have given is top, then you can give bottom, left, right, but it has to be on the same page. Then this example, here the value given is link to specific place on another page. Okay, so specific space also, place also is being specified. That means the reviews for product X. So if you want to know the reviews for product X, then for that specific place also you can go of a different page. That is, productx.html is the page, but the specific place is reviews. The next example here is mail is being given. Okay, a user's mail ID is being given. So when you click on this someone, that means the label here is someone. When you click on this someone, it will go on to that person's email. And here what we have this link to a JavaScript function. The label here is see this. When you click on this see this, it will execute this JavaScript function. And the last example which is there, it gives the telephone number of that particular person or something like that. So link to telephone automatically dials the number when user clicks on it using a smartphone browser. So what is the message label they have given is call toll free. The number is being given here. When you click on it, immediately your software will dial to that number. So these are the different ways in which you can make use of the A element to specify different location and sites. Next, which is there? Link text. Links with the label click here were once a staple of the web. That means whenever you used to use any website, they used to write here, click here. So we used to click on that and it used to go to some other website. So every web page used to have that. Today such links are frowned upon since they do not tell users where the link will take them. As a verb, click is become increasingly inaccurate when one takes into account the growth of mobile browsers. So wherever click is there, that particular word becomes very common when there are too many mobile browsers making use of those website. So whenever you are making use of click here, that usually is not entertained when it is appearing in a website. So instead of click here, what they are saying is, instead of that, textual link label should be descriptive. Okay, so instead of writing click here to see the race results, directly you have to mention race results or see race results, like that, VTU results. So immediately when you click on that, it will go to those website instead of mentioning click here to see the race results, like that. So little note they have given about how to make use of the link text. So if you want a person to click on that link, see that that text should be such a way that he presses, clicks on that. So it should be specific to where it has to go to, not just in common click here. The next topic here we have here is the URL absolute referencing. Okay, so we'll have here two types of referencing, URL absolute referencing and URL relative referencing. So you know that URL usually they help us to go to a different website. So URL you have to mention. Okay, so in that two parts are there, absolute referencing and relative referencing, which we'll be seeing in the later slides. Absolute referencing, which is there, it is used for external resources. Okay, so usually we'll see what it is. When referencing a page or resource on an external site, a full absolute reference is required. That is, whenever you are referencing to a page that is in a different site, okay, so that time you have to specify all this. That is the protocol. You have to mention the protocol http colon slash forward slash, and you have to specify the domain name www and any paths, and then finally the file name of the desired resource. So when you give such a big path, that time that reference is known as an absolute reference. Okay, so absolute reference, what will happen, the entire, for example, if you have like this www, now google.com is there. Okay, so this part which is there, it is an absolute reference. Okay, so you have to mention which protocol and which domain it is using, which page you want to go to. As you know, Google is not in our server. Google is a different server, so you have to mention that server name. Okay, so this type of references to external site, it is known as absolute reference. If it is a resource which is in your system itself, or it is in your server itself, that time it is known as relative reference. Relative means it is relative to your system, or it is related to your server. What happens here is, we also need to be able to successfully reference files within our site. So if the files are within our site, that time you make use of relative reference. If the files are in different site, then you make use of absolute reference. That is, absolute reference is like outhouse, and relative reference is like in-house. Okay. So we also need to be able to successfully reference file within a site. This requires learning the syntax for so-called relative referencing. Okay. So when referencing a resource that is on the same server as your HTML document, then you can use briefer relative referencing. Okay. If the URL does not include HTTP colon double slash, then the browser will request the current server for the file. When your file is in your server itself, in your current server, that time you need not make use of this HTTP colon double slash. Okay, this should be used when your file that you are requesting is in an external website. That time it is an absolute reference. But if it is in your current server, then it is a relative reference. URL relative referencing. We'll see if we are referencing to our current system or the current server. What is the syntax for that? As the syntax for referencing to an external website is this. If you are referencing to your current server, that time how to refer to those files. What we have here is, if all the resources for the site reside within the same directory, also referred to as a folder, then you can reference those other resources simply via their file name. So if the resources that you are searching for is in the same directory as your server, then no need of mentioning the path name by using the double slash and all. You have to directly mention the file name. However, most real world sites contain too many files to put them all within a single directory. For these situation, a relative path name is required along with the file name. That means most of the data will not be dumped in a single directory. There will be many directory, like how in your computer you will have C drive, D drive, E drive, F drive, desktop will be there, document will be there. So different types of directory will be there, but all those directories in your computer only. Okay, so if it is in your computer only, you have to specify the path name accordingly to that. Okay, so for these situations, a relative path name is required along with the file name. Okay, so the path name will be specifying how for absolute reference, absolute path, we had http colon double slash www.google.com. That is known as an absolute path name. But if it is in your current server, you have to make use of a relative path name. Okay, the path name tells the browser where to locate the file on the server. So if it is in your server only, where you have to go and search, that is specified in the path name. Okay, so path names, how to give path names on the web, follow which conventions? Unix conventions. Okay, so if we have studied about Unix, it makes use of those conventions to specify the path name. Forward slash, which is there, forward slashes are used to separate directory names from each other and from file names. So if they are within one if they are within many directories, then those directory has to be separated by slashes. That means if it is in user and then later on it is in student, and in student it is in some other folder, that time those all directories has to be separated by forward slashes. Okay, the next is double periods, double dot are used to reference a directory above the current one in the directory tree. That means if you have two directories and you have to specify to a directory which is above, that time you have to specify double dots. We will see, be seeing all these in this example, that is the URL relative referencing. In this they have shown us if the files are in your same directory or it is in the same server, then how to refer to them. So that all syntax is been given in this example.